So going back to your two biggest struggles in training for a triathlon, we just spoke about injury was one,
Yep.
and the other one is.
Risk aversion. And it's hilarious because, like, I was so afraid of getting injured, and I got injured anyways. You can't live your life afraid of injury, and that's what training was doing to me and that lifestyle I was in, because I was working a very safe job. And I think between working a safe job and being afraid of getting injured for to set back that career as well, I think I had just become a little risk averse. So it was my body was just in a rundown state 24/7. That's what training for a triathlon is.
So when we were in Mexico, like you'd be less likely to go on that hike or jump off a
100%,
waterfall or go
100%.
spear fishing and do stuff that is, there's always a risk. And especially the lifestyle you and me live. We are outdoors. We want to do, try new things. We want to push our bodies to the limit. So I could really see that, how that's debilitating in a
Yeah,
sense.
so when you're training, you're just always in a beat up state. Your body's always recovering. So then when I was playing beach volleyball and when I was doing extracurriculars or whatever they were, like, I was always just so much more prone to injury that I was having to say no to volleyball, which was like one of my favorite things to do in the world. No to rock climbing. And it's like I was having to say no to a bunch of the stuff that I loved. And so I think I had realized it was actually there was like a big key moment in my life that I always referred back to is Zach and I went to Nepal. I had just finished the Boston Marathon and we went to Nepal and like lived with some local families and it was just an incredible trip all around. But there was a moment by like a fire and we had to say things that we wanted to change about ourselves or like reflect on the life we were living and where we wanted to go, like which directions we want to change. And I just remember thinking one was like taking more risks, and I was like, I've been living scared and scared of getting injured, scared of losing this job that I had. And like I just remember that moment I thought about, like, I think I had to like light an incense and
Do a little prayer.
Have a little spiritual moment.
But it was cool just being able to reflect and be like, what is it that I'm feeling? And it was, I'm feeling like I'm afraid to take risks. And how can I take more risks? Like, it was just coming out here was taking a risk and going on this journey in Nepal. And I'm like, and I love it. Like, how I think I'm happiest when I'm taking risks. And so let's take more. So then I was just like, how can I take more? And like, flash forward, I was like, since I left Warner Brothers, it's been maybe 2.5 or 3 years now only, and it feels like a lifetime because I've just packed so many experiences in here. And
And that's what life is all about.
It's
It's
all
just
about saying
collecting
yeah,
experiences.
say yes and take that risk.
And the
It's
bigger the risk, the bigger reward.
absolutely.
From everything I went through, like my goal in life is to do what Haley has done, which is just like experience as much as possible. Haley's been to over 50 countries. She has, if anything, Haley, you have prioritized experience more than anyone I know in my life. And doesn't matter how much money you have or success or trophies or anything else. Like the most important thing are experiences. So for you, I'll give you a little round of applause because you've killed it in that. That's all I care about. Relationships, building relationships and experience. And you, on the other hand, you have done the most outdoors stuff I've ever met of anyone in my life. So a round of applause to you. Those are the two things I'm mostly jealous of.
I think I read a book a while ago, or it was in a podcast, something that was talking about like the resume when you leave college and you put all the places you worked and stuff like that, when really it's like we should be building our life resume and like where, what places have you been, like what charities have you helped, what have you actually done. And I think that's the most important resume you have.
And yeah, that's like one of my biggest life's purposes, and that's what I try and promote on this channel, is just go out and keep experiencing as much as possible.